Hi, my name is Arthur Hsu, Director of Training and Fitness Development for Indo Board Balance Trainer. The Indo Board Balance Trainer was created by Hunter Joffrey, who has over 40 years of skateboarding and surfing experience. The Indo Board Balance Trainer was originally created to train surfers out of the water, but has since become the most versatile balance training tool, training athletes from every sport. Today I'm going to introduce to you the Indo Board Original Training Package, which includes the Indo Board Deck, the Indo Flow Cushion, and the Indo Roller. I'm also going to teach you how to safely stand and use the Indo Board Balance Trainer with both the Flow Cushion and the Roller. But most importantly, we're going to learn today how to modify and progress many exercises on the Indo Board for all users of all goals. One of the misconceptions in the fitness industry is that balance training has to be still. That couldn't be further from the truth. As a matter of fact, balance training in its essence is about understanding and adapting to movement. Performing exercises on the Indo Board Balance Trainer will improve neuromuscular response. It will also help improve proprioceptive, postural, and kinesthetic awareness. But most importantly, training on the Indo Board is fun. We're going to start by standing on the Indo Board with a deflated Indo Flow Cushion. This is great for seniors, beginners, and for those who are post-rehab. We're going to start by keeping the nub side facing up on the floor. You're going to grab the Indo Deck with your fingers on the side and place it on top, center to the Indo Flow Cushion. You want to make sure that your fingertips are touching both sides and maintain the deck as parallel to the floor as possible. Then, we're going to stand behind the deck with our feet roughly shoulder width apart. Take one foot onto the deck, place all your weight down to make sure that the deck is touching the ground. Then place your other foot on the Indo deck and then balance. One of the ways to maintain proper balance is posture. Posture is very important, so keep your head and shoulders upright, keep your shoulders stacked on top of your hips, look straight across as if you're looking over the horizon with your knees slightly bent. The main goal of all exercises on the Indo Board Balance Trainer is to not let the deck touch the floor. To step off the Indo Board, simply lay the Indo Board to one side, cross step off, and you're off the Indo Board. We are now going to go into our second level of progression using the Indo Flow Cushion. Now, one of the benefits of using the Indo Flow Cushion is that it is easily adjustable because it's mouth inflatable. Simply bend and push the pin out, just like this. So you're going to press through, and then just use your finger and pull it out. All you have to do is blow one breath into the flow cushion, like this. Then you plug the pin back in, and there's your medium inflation. Medium inflation increases your instability and makes balancing more difficult. Remember to make sure that your fingertips touch both sides of the Indo Flow Cushion so that you know you're centered, and you want the deck to be as parallel as possible. Stand behind the deck, shoulder width apart. As you can see now, balancing becomes more challenging because I have a greater range of motion to control. What I want to go over with you right now is the different levels of progression using your foot stance. If you want to make the Indo Board Balance Trainer a little bit easier, bring your feet closer together towards the center like this. This will allow for more stability. Now, if you want to make it a little bit more challenging, step shoulder width. And then finally, if you want to find the most challenging level of progression in your foot stance, take your feet out to the edges of the deck. Now remember, postural awareness is key. Make sure you keep your head straight, look over the horizon with your eyes, and keep your shoulders stacked over your hips with your knees slightly bent. And again, our goal is to make sure that the deck does not touch the floor. And we're now going to transition to our final progression, which is full inflation of the Indo Flow Cushion. So this is the medium inflation. We're now going to go to full inflation. To fully inflate your IndoFlow cushion, just fill it up to the top until it's completely firm. Place the IndoFlow on the ground. Make sure you grab your deck center at the direct center. Place it over the IndoFlow cushion with your fingers touching both sides of the IndoFlow cushion. You want to make sure, and if you don't do it the first time, please readjust before you stand on the Indo board to make sure that it's parallel. Now we're going to stand on the Indo board. And what you're going to notice here is a different level of progression. A couple things you'll take note of here is that the shift of the board will slow down. However, the range of motion greatly increases, which causes more tension on the muscles. Everything remains the same as far as posture though. Keep your knees bent, shoulders above hips, keep your head on straight, look straight ahead, eyes over the horizon. We're now going to progress from the IndoFlow cushion to the roller. Let me preface this by saying that the roller is more advanced, a lot faster, so choosing the surface you're going to balance on is key. Try to stay away from hardwood floors, tile, or concrete surfaces as they increase the speed and instability of the roller. Instead, choose slower surfaces such as a yoga mat, or you can choose a wrestling mat. Most health clubs have rubber floors that you can utilize, or you can use carpets because carpets are slower, especially long-haired carpets. So when choosing a surface, try to choose a surface that will adhere to your ability level. Let's begin by placing one deck end on the roller and the other deck end on the floor. Put your down foot on the bottom and your high foot on the top. Your high foot is your gas pedal and your down foot is your brake pedal. As you shift over, pay more attention to your down foot or your brake pedal to help stabilize you as you shift over. Make sure that when you're shifting over, you try to keep your head on straight, looking forward and not looking down, because that will shift your body weight off. Make sure that when you're on your deck, that posture awareness is key. Stand up nice and straight with your knees bent, shoulders over your hips, and if you can, maintain focus over the horizon looking straight ahead. If you must look down, be very careful not to lean forward and look down as that will pull you off center. But instead, tuck your chin in and look down slightly, but then look up as soon as you can to maintain proper control. We are now going to demonstrate how to assist your client onto the Indo board balance trainer. Chip here is going to demonstrate the client's point of view, and I'm going to demonstrate the trainer's point of view. So Chip, take your down foot and place it on the floor of the Indo board, and take your high foot and place it on the top end of the Indo board. You want to make sure that your client has a nice wide stance on this Indo board. So Chip, please make sure you have a nice wide stance on the edge of the deck. Make sure you refer to the posture, shoulders above hips, knees slightly bent, looking straight ahead over the horizon, in this case, my top of my head. As a trainer, you're gonna stay close to your client to make sure that they don't shift their weight over the front and take themselves off center of gravity. Chip is going to take his hands and grab my wrists. My arms are folded in a 90 degree position. As Chip shifts to balance, I am going to shift with him so that he has something to hold on to as he gets up. Ready, Chip? Let's go. It might take one, two, maybe even three times to shift up to balance, but as long as you're there helping him, he should maintain proper control. Now, what you want to do is transition from a grip to fingertips. So Chip, slightly release your grip, put your fingertips on, bend at the knees. When he exhibits control, you can now progress to no hands at all. So Chip, I want you to take your hands off, and I'm going to move my hands close to his hips in case he starts to shift too much. I'm here to catch him. A second option to help assist your client onto the Indo board is to grab your client by the side of their waist and have your client hold onto your shoulders. This allows you to hold them from their midpoint, which gives you better control of their body as they're shifting onto balance. So Chip, please stand on the Indo deck. Once again, remember that wide edge-to-edge stance, and also make sure to repeat postural alignment. Shoulders above hips, slight bend in the knees, and make sure they're looking straight over the horizon, in this case, the top of my head. So I'm gonna ask Chip to grab onto the side of my shoulder. I'm going to put my hand on the side of his hips. Also make sure that you move a little bit closer so they don't lean their body weight over the center, okay? Now, I'm going to take my step ahead of time so I can meet Chip when he shifts over. Chip, are you ready?
Yep.
Okay, shift. Now I have good control over where his body is going, and it makes him feel more secure balancing on the indo board. Now, as Chip gets more comfortable, I'm going to ask Chip to release his hands off my shoulders gradually, and then when I can feel that he has control, I will slowly remove my hands further away from his waist. Now, if he starts to shift too much, I can always put my hand back, or he can put his hands back on my shoulders. Good job, Chip. Now that we've gone over some basic use and setups on the indo board balance trainer, we're going to take some traditional base exercises and transfer them onto the indo board to create a fun and challenging environment that will enhance your results. So we're now going to demonstrate the different styles of push-ups that you can perform on the indo board with the flow cushion. The first one will be a basic push-up. Place your hands on the width of the deck. Maintain a stable and steady plank position. Now an option for this is that we can now turn the board lengthwise. If you want to perform an offset push-up or have a stable, unstable combination push-up, use a deck in its length position with one hand on the deck centered and one hand on the floor. So you have one unstable surface and one stable surface. Again, the width of your footprint increases or decreases your stability. Perform the push-up. You can increase the instability by bringing the floor arm off the ground. You can shift to a side plank. You can even go into a one-arm push-up. So those are your different options using balance and instability. We're now going to move into the plank series to improve our core stabilization. And what we're going to do is we're going to plank with the indo deck upside down so we can have the smooth surface for which to place our forearms on. So you're going to place the indo board deck upside down, but remember to grab the board in the middle and center it on the flow cushion so that the board is as perpendicular to the floor as possible. Then you're going to place your forearms at shoulder width apart on the deck. Extend your legs out to plank. Now remember, the wider the stance, the more stable. The closer the stance, the more unstable. And then you can still go to a single leg. Okay? Bringing your hands together is another option, or keeping your hands apart. So now we can add different variations to the plank by moving our leg in different positions to increase the weight variance towards our trunk or our core. Place your forearms on the deck again. Shoulder width apart, feet starting off at hip width apart, or you can bring it together for more instability. You can start with your leg up in extension, out in abduction, in flexion, or abducted like a fire hydrant. So now we're gonna try those same plank progressions on our hands in a push-up position style plank. We're gonna flip the deck back over right side up. Make sure you grab the board in the center. Place your fingers on the edges of the indo flow cushion. Make sure your deck is parallel to the floor, as even as possible. When you're placing your hands shoulder width apart on the deck, make sure your shoulders are directly over your wrist. Start with your feet about hip to shoulder width apart. If you want to challenge your stability more to become more unstable, bring your feet closer together. Extend your leg up. Out to the side, bring your knee in, out to the side again like a fire hydrant, bring it close together, through the other side as you come down for a push-up, push right up, turn it around to a scorpion, come down into the push-up, and as you push right back up, maintaining the board off the floor, bring your feet back together, shoulder width apart. So this is a ground-based exercise where we're actually now focusing on the lower body, specifically the hips. So we're going to do an indo board hip bridge. Place your feet on the Indo deck about shoulder width apart. You're gonna lay on your back. Make sure your feet are flat on the deck. Try to keep the deck level without having the deck hit the floor. Hands to the side. Press your shoulder blades back, palm facing up. Pressing through your feet, lift your hips up to a bridge position so that your knees, hips, and shoulders are diagonal. And then bring your hips back down. And then repeat. For more instability, bring your hands up off the floor. And repeat the hip press. So your next progression is to go to a one-legged hip bridge, in which case you would take the single leg that you're gonna press off of and place it center to the deck, right above the IndoFlow cushion. The other leg will be extended out. You can have it off the floor to help you at first, or you can keep it suspended from the get-go for more advanced movements. From here, you'll lay back down, palms facing up, shoulders against the floor. Pressing off the leg that's on the deck, lift your hips up, pressing through your feet as a whole, bring it back down. You can change the lever arm of your suspended leg by bringing that knee in. This will make the exercise a little bit easier. And then for more challenge, extend the leg back out or out to the side, but maintaining neutral hip alignment.